We're going to do some model building today. I'm going to show you some tricks. Stay tuned. Welcome to another episode of Frank Curry's Homestead. Going to be working on a model. First, I want to show you how I make the floor mats. Let me show you. Okay. So what I do is I put in the search bar floor mats. Floor mats for cars or pickups, whatever you want. And say I want these ones right here. Okay, click on it. I bring up the view, the image, a view image like that, and I'll save it. Then you can take your, let me close this out here. Open up my files. Okay, here's some right here. Okay, and there's my image. Okay, that's my saved image. Then what I will do, I will bring it into this is the one I use. It's called the Greeting Card Factory. Actually, I'll exit out of that. Then what I do is I'll bring that image in here, and I will size it down to the size I need for the model. And you just bring it in through your add a graphic from file. Here, got the model stuff. Okay, here's them right there. Okay, there it is. And you just take it, and you know, you might have to do two or three different sizes on the page. Pick your size. Downsize them to whatever size you need. Okay, I'll bring it in. Another one. Let's see, make that one just a tad bigger. You know, do two or three of them and get it to the size you need. Print it off. Okay. And I'll hit print. And we'll get back to you in the other room. Okay. Once you get it printed off, you got your pictures on the paper. I take and use an acrylic sealer. It's the only one I got. And it's what I use. And you will spray your picture so it seals it front and back, and then I take it and I'll lay it on something that it won't stick to. I have basically like a little cookie rack, a baking rack, and I set it on there and let it dry. And then you take them and cut them out. Take a pair of tweezers, a little bit of glue, and stick them onto the floor of your model. Down in here on the floor. I usually do it before I put all together. This one, I chose not to put any floor mats in it. I wanted to make it look like carpet. right down, let it dry, and then put them in there, basically just glue them in. There's that little trick for you. Now, next little trick is, if I show you here, you can see, I'm going to get that light in there just right. You can see the green on the seats right here. That, what it does, I do it with flat paint, and it makes it look like leather. And then I go, you go to your hobby store, and you buy this little, these little bottles of acrylic paint that they use, and you paint, you can get them all in all different colors, everything, and then you paint your seats, and it also comes out looking like a leather. Okay, and that. And on your instrument panels, some of your models will come with on a decal sheet of your instrument panels, little decals you place down in there. I don't use them. I go on the internet and I look up like instrument panels, speedometers, whatever you can find, and bring up a picture of your the ones you want. I do the same thing just like I do with the floor mats. I do the same thing. I downsize them, do several little pictures of them, and then I print them out, spray paint them with the acrylic paint, let them dry, and then you can put those down in there with a little bit of glue, and it looks more real. So that's another little trick for you. Now on the engine, let me get it up here, where the wires are, find something to point here with, where your wires are right here, where they come out, like where the distributor cap is, the spark plug wires. I don't actually use a distributor that they have in the model kit. What I do is I drill a hole with my little hand drill, and I'll drill the holes for where the spark plug wires go. And then what I do is I take the wire, which, again, go to your hobby store, and I buy these little spools of real fine wire. You can get them all in different colors. Everything from black to, you can get wild, like that one, wild pink. Whatever color you want. These ones are on in the green to match the color of the car. And what I do is I cut 8 wires, kind of long, and on the end where the distributor goes, I twist them. I make a real tight twist, so they don't come apart, kind of fold them over, and then I'll put it down through my hole, put my glue around it, let it dry, and then I can maneuver my wires wherever I need to, here, to my wires. Then, I haven't done it on this one yet, but then I'll take, and where my wires come up, then I'll paint it silver, black, something like that, and you make it look like a distributor. So that's what I do on that. That's another little tip. When you paint your models, get everything like your mirrors, unless they're chrome, get them attached, like I did here. Put it on an old paint can, just an empty paint can. And then you paint it. This one was painted by, you know, the can paint. And when I paint it, I go make sure, like, this is my paint, okay? I make sure I start on the outside of the car, move across the car, get over here, come on. Get it across and go past the car. I have rubber gloves you buy at the store, put them on, that way you're not painting your hand. Go across, up top, across, past the car, okay? Always go in just light passes, you know, about a good 6 to 10 inches away. And you do the same thing all over. Let that coat dry. Or almost get dry. Come back with a second coat, same way. Real lightly, all the way around it. Around your front, same way. Start past the car, in past the car. I usually do 3 to 4 light coats. That's about all it takes. Same way on your, like this one, here's the hood. Same way, old paint can, just tape to the top. I do the same thing. I come over one way, same way. Then the next time I paint it, I'll turn it. And I'll do it again. Same way on the body of the car. Same way, do it in different pattern, like a cross pattern. That way, if you have any, like this hood has indentations around it, I want to make sure I get all areas painted. Now another thing is, I've been building cars for model cars and airplanes a little over 40 years. Well, it could be about 45 years. Well, yeah, it could be about 45 years. So, another thing is I keep parts. Any parts that I don't use on other models, I throw them in a box. Same way with decals, I throw them in a box. There's an engine. Small block 350, so it's a Chevy. I got tires, rims. I got all kinds of things in here. I mean, that way I can think outside the box. Change the model, you know. I look at it as, okay, I'm going to a car show. What do I want to see? Me, I like modified cars. It's not stock. I do like some stock, but I'm more into cars that people's thought outside the box and modified their cars. So that's some tips and tricks for you. Hopefully you liked the video and it gave you some information. Once again, like I said, I've been building cars for over 45 years. So if you have any questions, I'll see what I can do to answer them. Just put it in the comments. If you'd like to see some of my model cars that I showed in another video and you want to specifically see one, let me know. I'll put a link to that right up here and also at the end of the video. use your imagination, and I'll see you on the next one. But don't forget, smile today, smile tomorrow, and you're going to smile all week, guaranteed. Here's the suggested videos for you. While you're here, why don't you check out some of these other videos that's going to be right up here, right in this area, over here somewhere. Just watch it forward in this area over here. Okay?